The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Mr. Excel XL, a book with 40 Excel tips, plus cartoons, cocktails, tweets, and jokes. Learn yourself from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1977, Fiddle Handle for 1, 2, 3. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, everyone knows how to use the fiddle handle, but there's good tricks in this video, so hang on. Fiddle handle, type in January, grab the little square dot at the bottom of the cell, and you can drag across, or you can drag down, and it will fill the series. How cool is that? It works automatically out of the box with months, right? Works with month abbreviations. Oh, I have to tell you, I had the weirdest nightmare last night. I was thinking about what podcast I'm going to do today. I typed in Jan. I grabbed the fill handle and dragged. I got Jan, Marcia, Cindy, Bobby, Greg, and Peter. Okay, that still works. Works with days of the week. It works with abbreviations of days of the week. They understand that at Microsoft, at Excel, they love accountants. Accountants deal in quarters all the time. Q1, Q4, after Q4 goes back to Q1. You can spell quarter in any conceivable way. QTR1, even first quarter. The one that drove me crazy for years, though, and this is the one that I love. If you have to fill quarters and years, and what I always used to do, I always used to try Q1 2018 or 2016, and that's just chaos because I get Q1 of each year, right? Undo. But what you have to do is one Q, and then after the Q, put anything you want, a space, a dash, apostrophe, just about anything works in there. 1Q 2018, click and drag, and it will fill 2, 3, 4, but then bump up the 18 to 19, right? So the whole trick there is to have the number at the beginning. Frankly, any word and a number, so room 101 will automatically fill. Okay, so Excel can do all of these, January, the days of the week, months of the year, quarters, dates, but it can't do this one. Put in the number 1. What would any rational person think you're going to get next? 2, 3, 4. What do you actually get? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Thanks, Microsoft, for being so consistent. You can fill all these other series, but you can't figure out that after 1 comes 2. And what people tell me is, well, hey, just give it a pattern. Put in the 1 and the 2. Yeah, that's true, but I didn't have to put in Jan and Feb. I could just put in January. So, beautiful trick here. This is from row 2 in Kent, Ohio at the Myonsky Conference. Again, 8 years ago doing a live Power Excel seminar there. Someone said, oh, no, you can do this. Hold down the Control key. What? Hold down the Control key. Sure enough, when you hold down the Control key, all of a sudden, Excel knows how to count. How was anyone ever supposed to figure that out? In fact, how did this lady in Kent, Ohio figure it out? It had to be like late on a Friday afternoon where she's falling asleep and accidentally falls asleep with her elbow on the Control key. I have no idea. Now, my friend Andrew Spain from Huntsville, Alabama, great Excel trainer and Excel consultant there, said, well, if you forget to hold down the Control key, right, so you start to drag and you see you're getting 1, 1, 1s, then after the fact, while you're doing the drag, hold down the Control key. See that little plus sign right there? I'm going to have to zoom in so we can see it. The plus sign next to the plus sign says that we are going to fill the series instead of adding. If you just completely forget, if you just drag the ones down there and then you let go, right here in any version except for the latest version of Excel 2016, you're going to have autofill options. Click that icon and choose fill series instead of copy cells. However, it's broken in this latest version of Excel 2016. Or just because I feel like I need to be complete and thorough, if you choose the number and a blank cell to the right of the number and drag down, that will automatically fill the 2, 3, 4. All right, a couple more tricks here. Dates, just normal. Just grab the fill handle, drag, you get the next day, the next day, the next day. What if you need to copy 131, you don't want it to extend? Hold down Control. Control seems to say do the opposite of what you would normally do. All right, if you work Monday through Friday, let's change this to a long date here. If you want to fill it just the work week, Monday through Friday, right-click and drag. Right-click and drag, we'll go down 250 rows, and choose Fill Weekdays. Fill Weekdays will fill just the Monday through Friday dates. Double-click there to make it wide enough for the longest value. That works great if you work Monday through Friday. If you work anything else, Monday through Saturday, Tuesday through Saturday, every day except for off Wednesday, well, hey, Microsoft just doesn't care about you. What if we have to fill months, so we want the last of every month? Right-click and drag, and we will say fill months, and they're smart enough to go. They know that there's not 31 days in February, but in 2020, there were 29 days in February. Specific day of the year, so right-click and drag, and say fill years. It will give us that day of each year. Hey, here's a great trick from my friend Bob Umbliss, author of the Excel Outside the Box series. I think I stole this from his book. If you have to do payroll, the 15th and last, select them both, right-click and drag, and then say fill months, and it will always fill the 15th and the last of the month. Great, great trick there from Bob Umless. All right, here's a recap of the concepts in this video. Some of my favorites for quarters and years, use one Q and then anything and the year. It has to be one Q, not Q1. Hold down the Control key to have one fill to 1, 2, 3. Hold down the Control key to copy dates instead of filling. Then right-click and drag the fill handle to fill weekdays, months, and years. All right, all of that is in this book, Mr. Excel XL, with more than 40 other tips. Go ahead, click that I in the top right-hand corner there. You can order the book in either print or ebook. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.